Hello, welcome to my talk on Leibniz's invention of calculus. This is a talk on how Leibniz smartly applied his transmutation theorem to solve a complicated integral problem. A problem led to a series for pi, the Leibniz series. In this talk, I will introduce a brief summary of Leibniz's calculus on the transmutation theorem, an examiner integral for the area of a quadrant of a circle with a radius 1.0, the application of Leibniz's transmutation theorem for this example, the simplified integral for the area of the quadrant after applying Leibniz's transmutation theorem, the Leibniz series for pi, a simple and an interesting series for pi, although it converges very slow, and the discussions on the applications of Leibniz's transmutation theorem. In this slide, a brief summary of the Leibniz transmutation theorem is given. The Leibniz transmutation theorem was proposed for solving some difficult integral problem. For instance, giving a curve from A to B, and the area under the curve would be given as the integral on y given by this. The Leibniz transmutation theorem includes two steps. Step 1 for the variable transform, which transforms the variable y to z. Z is calculated as this, the value on y-axis to the cross point of the tangent line t and the axis y. The second step is the transform of the integral given as this. So the integral on y is transformed to the integral on z by this relation. Obviously, the first term on the right-hand side here can be easily calculated if the function y is given. Now we examine an example. The target is to find the area of a quadrant of a circle of radius 1.0. Hence, the area of the quadrant would be pi divided by 4, and the integral would be given as this. Now we look at the equation of the circle. It is centered at x equaling to 1, y equaling to 0. So the circle is governed by this equation. Hence, we have the relation between y and x as this. So the integral would be on this square root function. However, in Leibniz's era, there was no direct method to integrate the square root function, since Taylor series was not invented yet. Although Newton's binomial series could be used, but Newton did not publish it yet. What Leibniz did was to find a method to solve the problem. The method is called transmutation theorem. Also, from the equation for the circle, we can obtain the differential equation as this. Hence, we can obtain the derivative y with regard to x given as this. Now, based on Leibniz's transmutation theorem, here we can calculate the new variable z given by this variable transform. In here, substitute the derivative y with regard to x, and we obtain the relation as this. So if we square that we could have the relation as this. Thus, we can also obtain x as a function of z given as this simple expression. Here we can see when x equaling to 0, z is 0. And when x equaling to 1, z equaling to 1. In the step 3, we can obtain the integral transform, the integral on y to the integral on z. Here we get the expression as this. Therefore, the integral is transformed from the integral on y to the integral on z. See here the shade added. From the expression of z and x, it seems the integral on z would not be simpler than the integral on y. However, Leibniz solved the problem. If we look at the plot here, the shade area is the integral on z, which is also can be calculated as the area of the square less the area of the white in the square. Mathematically, this integral would be given as this. Here, the left-hand side is the shaded area in this plot, and this is the area of the square. This, and this is the area of the white. So the integral can be expressed as this. Now the final integral of the example would be given as this and this. And now the problem becomes very simple. You see, the integral from original square root function to this simple expression. Since here, the function 1 of 1 plus z square would be given as this. So substitute this into the integral. We have the integral as this and this. This would be very easy, even in the Leibniz era, which would be given as this. So put all this together, we have an expression for a quad pi given as an infinite series. This is the Leibniz series for pi. Although Mordava in around 1400 and James Gregory in 1668 both obtained the series for arctan x, they both missed the last step to specify the series for pi given as this. Here and the next slide, the discussions would be made for Leibniz transmutation theorem. From the previous example, we can see how Leibniz smartly used his transmutation theorem to solve the complicated integral problem. For instance, Leibniz used a setup of a quadrant C in this plot. In fact, this is a very unusual way to put the circle quadrant, but it is the way Leibniz could solve the problem. Otherwise, it might not work. See the next slide. Now look at the variable transform from y to z given in this calculation. And for this setup, the differentiation y with regard to x is given as this. So put this together, we got z given as this as a function of x. If we look at the expression, we can see if x is not equaling to 0, z would be smaller than 1.0, which can be seen in this plot. One question is, when x equaling to 0, what is z from this expression? Since if we substitute x equaling to 0 into the expression, we would have an expression for z given by 0 divided by 0. I know mathematicians would hate to see such an expression as this. The question is, if we do have an expression as this, what is z exactly? Here, we can, based on L'Hopital's rule, if z would be given as 0 divided by 0, then z can be calculated as the derivative of the numerator and the derivative of the denominator, respectively. So we have the expression as this and this, and we can see when x equaling to 0, z would be 0. This is why we say x equaling to 0, z is 0. In here, we look at a different layout of the quadrant of the circle. See this quadrant, and the circle would be given as this equation. Thus, we have the derivative y with regard to x given as this. So if we put all this together, we have the expression for z as the function of x given as this. And now, we can have a check. When x equaling to 0, z would be 1. However, when x equaling to 1, z would be infinite. Once this happens, z becomes an infinite, the Leibniz transmutation might not work, since we can obtain the relation as this, and we solve z as the function of x, or x as the function of z. So the problem, the original integral is given as this, and use the Leibniz transmutation, we have the integral given as this. So in this regard, we can see after using the Leibniz transmutation theorem, the integral becomes more complicated. Therefore, use Leibniz transmutation, we need to get the layout of the plot correctly.